back, everybody. Here to show us how to create the perfect accessory for your look this holiday season is Orly. Orly, these are looking fantastic.
Cameron?
I mean, maybe not for me.
But maybe for Vanessa. Maybe
definitely for Vanessa.
Daughter.
Definitely for my daughter.
Can we discuss?
Yeah, talk to me.
If I were a hand model. And you would get a
That's subtle.
Look at this.
That's very subtle.
Look at this. So fun. They are such a great DIY. I love the idea of using real gift wrapping. One of the benefits of working on Hallmark Channel is that I'm now fully aware of all the awesome Hallmark gift wrapping. Like anywhere I see it, I'm like,
And you can take it and make it into something fantastic like
this.
That's not how my mind works. Thank goodness for you.
That's my gift.
No, but really, like you mentioned, Vanessa, Layla would absolutely love these. Yeah. So let's dive right in. Let's get started.
Yeah, so what you need are these tiny little bows.
Okay.
You just need the little miniature ones. These are about an inch long.
Those are just real bows. Just bows that you, just little mini bows.
The cutest bows you ever saw.
Okay.
And the first one I want to do is to make the earrings actually that I'm wearing here. And they're called, it's called kidney wire, which is such an interesting name, but this is, there you go. So you can see how they sort of dangle there on the end. And if you look at them right here, this is the way that they hang. So this is the top part of your ear, and down here is where your charm would hang.
All right.
So it's very simple, and this first one that I'm gonna do is gonna be no glue at all. We're just gonna hang it on. That way, if you wanted to change them out, change out the colors, wear different ones for different parties, you could do that because we're not gluing them.
Okay.
So let's come down here. I'm gonna show you how to do it. So first thing we're gonna do is we're just gonna open the wire. So you just pop it open, that's how they work. And now we grab our bow. I wanna make sure that we take off the backing because not only do we not see, we don't need this, but we also don't wanna see it from the backside.
Right.
So just simply rip that off and you won't see it at all. One more thing is each of them have this little flat tab, which I just feel like kind of ruins all the cool rounded corners.
Right, it kind of gives it away that
it's,
you know what I mean, versus making it look like some jewelry. So you get rid of that bad boy right there.
You just chop that little guy.
Okay.
Now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna hang the bow on here. So you take this little loop that you've got, and you could do it two ways. You could either start it here and loop
it around.
And
go all the way around.
Yeah, but I'm gonna try just going right in to the loop.
Because you're fancy.
Because I'm super fancy, although let's see if I can do it. Super fancy.
But that's the idea, right? You just get it right on the edge there, and now it's hanging. Oh, yeah.
It's so easy that I have to do it now, or I'm just going to have to hurt someone.
I think you should.
There we go.
Okay. There you go.
So there you go. You can see it hangs, and the cool thing about it is that because it's hanging loose, it moves. So it sparkles, and it looks really beautiful. And then you would just put this on, and you just close it. And that's exactly how I'm wearing mine
right now.
So
yours are just hanging right there like
that? They're just hanging just like that. And actually, if we could come right here, I want to show just a couple different versions.
Okay.
So this one right here, these are the similar ones that I've done in just different colors. It's on the kidney wire. And now if we go right down to the bottom, these are drop earrings. And these are those ones that are really cool. They slide through and you can actually adjust the length so you see the chain behind your ear.
Oh, yeah.
And if you wanted, with these, they kind of twist and turn. So a cool idea is to actually double up two of them. So you can see this almost looks like a full kind of bow. You almost can't tell what it is, that they're bows.
Right.
Because I've sandwiched two of them together, which makes them like fully 3D,
which is
a really cool idea.
Now, are those hanging like the other ones too? Or
no, those are glued on.
Those are glued on.
So for these little ones, you can hang them. These, I'll actually turn around and show you. See, it's just got a little tab of glue right there with the chain.
And in order to hide that side, like you said,
you
just kind of double it up.
Yeah, another one.
Okay, I love it.
Let's move on to rings, shall we?
Let's go to rings.
Yes. Okay, so for the rings, you can see right here, I want to show, you can, you know, put a stone in them, which I think is really cool. So we've got a nice big red stone here, but you could also sort of adjust the size if
you
wanted.
So how do you attach the stone or the crystal right to the bow like that?
So guys, this is what we're gonna do. First things first, right? We remove our wrapping because we don't need that.
No.
And now right here, see that little center, the one little loop that's in the middle?
Right.
That's where we're gonna attach our stone. And I'm gonna use a small one for this.
Okay.
So what I'm gonna do is just put a little E6000 on the table. I'm actually gonna use this one. It's more sparkly. And now grab your pliers and just sort of dab it in the glue.
Okay.
And now I'm gonna drop it on. And I just now wanna kind of push this down and give it a second to dry. The E6000 normally takes a little bit of time, so I have one that's already dried, so that's ready to go.
Beautiful.
And now all you do is this E6000, we're just gonna do a little bit. These aren't heavy, so you don't need a ton on here.
Now you just grab this, where would you find one of these sort of blank slate rings like this?
So it's actually really cool because this is something that's, you know, used for jewelry making. You would just wanna look up, like, pick the type of jewelry you want, earring, necklace, ring, and just type in base. So if you typed in ring base, earring base. You're going to find all the jewelry making, so you can either look for those online or any regular craft store.
Fantastic.
And then...
So now that's on there, and you, like you sort of mentioned before, you could use different size stones. I mean, you obviously got the big red one. I was going to call it a ruby.
It is kind of ruby-ish. Yeah, it's
ruby-ish.
Real fancy. But that's
ruby-esque.
Actually... The cool thing is that, so if you're using a larger stone, you would sort of push it inside these little rivets, that, you know, the little loops, or you could have it floating like these earrings up here, which have the little floating stones sitting on the outside. So it just depends on the style of stone that you want to use. But yeah, a little E6000, or if you do the kidney ones, they just kind of hang.
You know what I'm thinking?
Tell me.
I'm thinking these would make a great gift because they're already gift wrapped. See what I did
That's
there?
That's so good. I feel like one of these would be really great for your daughter. Can we pick a color
yes,
for her?
Yes, please,
tell me. You know her better than I do. Tell me.
I think I'll go with the monochromatic look in the front.
Ooh, this one?
Yeah. Oh. Pretty sparkly.
I love it.
That's great. Oh, my gosh. Go. I'm going to send another Orly DIY photo with my daughter.
Yes. Those are my favorite pictures.
I'm telling you, I keep them coming. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This is going to be great. Layla's going to love this, too.